Windows Notepad, we've all used it, and you think you might know everything there is to know about it, but you don't. I'm going to go over some secret features in Notepad that you probably never knew about before. There's a couple that are also hidden in plain sight, you might say. So let's get into it. Starting off with number one, did you know that if you open a Notepad text file and start it out with .log in all caps and then save that text file, the next time you open it up and every other time, it will automatically create a timestamp and add it. And this will basically let you create a timed log entry or diary type file. So if there's something that you need to keep track of, you could create a shortcut to it on the desktop. And then anytime whatever thing happens, you simply open the file and then immediately type in whatever the thing is, and it'll automatically have created a timestamp for that. Related to that is another feature that's more hidden in plain sight you probably didn't know about, and that is if you hit F5 or go into the edit and then time date button, it will actually add the same time and date timestamp that we just saw, except you can add it manually. Next, if you ever need to print something through Notepad, you can actually customize the header and footer. If you go into the file and then page setup and then look in the header and footer sections, there's a few character codes that you can use, such as the and L character. This will left align any characters that follow it. The and C will center any characters that follow it, and R will right align anything following it. And in addition to alignment, you can also use other character codes such as and D, which will put the current date, and then and T will put the current time, so you can timestamp when you're printing something. Or you can also put and F, which will print the name of the document, or the and P code will put the page number. Next, there are several command line arguments that you can use to launch Notepad with a few options from the command line if you ever feel so inclined to do this. For example, you can use /A or /W and then the file name to open the file with an encoding type of either ANSI or Unicode if you wanted to do that for some reason. Or you can also manually change this if you go to File, Open. There's also like that option drop down. You can do that through that as well. There's also a command line argument to print a file. So you do that with /P and then the file name, and that will print the file. So if you want to print a whole bunch of files at once, you can create some kind of script for it. And then also /PT is like a really advanced way of printing if you for some reason need to specify an exact printer and driver DLL and that sort of thing. That's probably not very common, but it's there if you ever need to do it. And then finally, there's a pretty strange command line argument called /.setup. And this puts Notepad in a very strange mode where it basically is not interactable. It gets rid of the minimize button. I found that you can't really click on the window and focus it. In fact, it doesn't even show the icon in the taskbar, and you can't type anything into it. And the only way I found to even close it was to go into the task manager and close the Notepad process. Apparently, this is some kind of special mode, I guess, that used to be used in some kind of setup mode, I think like way back in even the Windows XP days, maybe to just display information without letting anyone edit it. I don't know. I don't think it's used anymore, but it's there if you want a fun Easter egg. Next up, let's go over some features that aren't really a secret, but you might not have realized have been added to Notepad recently. Yes, Microsoft has been updating Notepad quite a bit recently. And to ensure that you have the latest version of Notepad, you can get it from the Microsoft Store that has the newer version. But I'll also show you how you can install also, in addition, the classic version of Notepad. There's a optional thing for that. Anyway, in the new Notepad, by default, it will actually save sessions. So if you close Notepad while something is being edited, some document, and then you reopen it, it will actually open it back up, even if you didn't save it. This is pretty similar how other software like Notepad++ works by default. You can change this behavior if you go into the Notepad settings and look for the When Notepad Starts option. And I personally have this set to open a new window instead of the previous session, because if I want to take notes that I actually care about losing, then I'll use Notepad++. But if I just want something that's very temporary, that's when I'll use Notepad, so I don't really need it to remember anything, but it's up to you. Also, you might not have realized that the new Notepad has features like spell check. You can toggle that on and off, autocorrect as well, and even dark mode. So there you go. Now, if you do have nostalgia for the old classic Notepad, the simple one, you can actually still get it if you go into the settings for Windows, then go into System, Optional Features, and then look for Notepad System. However, even after you enable that, we're not done yet, because even though it has this classic version installed, even if you, for example, go into System32 and run notepad.exe, which is the classic one, it'll still open the new version probably. However, you can change that. And to change that, what you do is go into the settings again and then apps, and then advanced app settings, then app execution aliases, and then toggle off Notepad. After you do this, now you can choose to run the new version of Notepad by like typing it into the start menu as you would, or if you do want to run the classic version of Notepad, you can go into the system directory and then create a shortcut to notepad.exe or just run it directly. Probably you want to make a shortcut to it. And now you can basically kind of choose which one to do. Now you will notice it shows a banner talking about the new version of Notepad. Apparently that will only show up the first time if you exit out, and then it won't show up again. So just do that. Finally, I figured I'd talk about some secret hidden stuff that has to do with the older version of Notepad. First of all, it turns out that as part of that Windows XP leak a few years ago, Notepad, the source code of Notepad, was part of that. And in there were some interesting things. For example, there's a whole section called unused status bar codes, and this block is not in the actual compiled version of Notepad because it contains a thing that says if defined, which would only enable that block of code if like it was compiled in a special way, which apparently was not. Anyway, this kind of reveals that in a development version of Notepad, it also had the ability in the status bar to show more information about the open file, such as whether it's a hidden file, if it's compressed, encrypted, that sort of thing, that is not enabled in regular Notepad. So that would have been cool if they enabled that in the regular version. Another interesting thing is if you do look at the old version of Windows XP Notepad, it pretty much looks exactly the same as the new version classic Notepad, which is newer. It's not like it's the same exact version. The old one just has a few less things like searching with Bing, which I don't know if I've ever used that, but the core stuff is all the same. And I will say, I do actually like the look of the old Windows XP Notepad icon. I think the colors look just cooler. They're a bit more saturated. It changed to this other one in Windows Vista, and then I think it's basically the same until now. Although, unfortunately, the old version of Notepad icon was only 48 by 48 pixels, so very small, whereas the new one's 256, much higher resolution. Finally, I thought I'd mention a historical fun fact. Some of you actually may remember this. In the old version of Windows XP Notepad, there was a bug that kind of went viral, and people discovered if you type in the characters Bush hid the facts, like President Bush, and then you saved it, and then opened it again, the text would be all garbled, and people thought, oh, it's a conspiracy. But then it turns out, in actuality, it's a bug that has to do with how Notepad detects the type of encoding that's used. And if you put any string of characters and words in that sequence where it's this many characters and then a space and then this many characters, any set of those, it'll do the same exact thing. So it's not just specific to that exact string of characters. Someone just figured out they could make it sound a lot more significant if they put some kind of sentence in there. Of course, this was fixed a long time ago. It does not occur in the Windows Vista and later versions of Notepad. So I'd be curious to know which of you knew all this. You're a Notepad expert already, or maybe you learned something, or maybe I missed something somehow. You can let us know down in the comments. If you want to keep watching though, next I'd recommend where I talked about Windows calculator secrets. There's actually quite a bit more in there that I think you'll find interesting. I could put that link right there. And if you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm. And thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.